everyone. Today we're talking about wine and chocolate. So those are two of our favourite vices. You're either going to like one or the other or both. And we're certainly going to be discussing the health benefits of wine and chocolate, because most of us have heard that they're good for you. But how much can you actually have until it becomes a bad thing? So I think that's important for us perhaps to discuss today. And it's not to shame anyone, and it's not to make anyone feel any, you know, bad about what they're drinking or eating. It's more to just bring some awareness, and also to try and be aware that if you're having too much of a good thing, it can actually be a harmful thing. So I think the first thing we'll talk about is the health benefits. What are the health benefits? The health benefits are the antioxidant and anti-aging components of wine and chocolate. There's something called flavonoids or resveratrol in wine, and they're anti-cancer, anti-aging and anti-inflammatory. So they can prevent things like heart attacks, premature aging and certain types of cancer. In chocolate, there's flavonoids. So they're things like anti-cancer, anti-aging, once again, and anti-inflammatory. With wine, how much can you actually have? Most of us don't meet up to the recommended alcohol standards in Australia, which I think is interesting. The experts say no more than 100 mils for women per day, with two alcohol-free nights a week. And for men, they can have 200 mils on five nights a week with two alcohol-free nights a week. Most of us probably don't have that much, but that's something to keep in mind. That's what the experts are saying. For health, no more than that. Any more than that, and you negate the health benefits of the red wine you're drinking. With chocolate, how much can you actually have? That's a 100 gram block of chocolate. Experts say that you can have up to 50 grams a day, and that's considered an okay amount. But if you're trying to lose weight, keep in mind that that's a 40-minute ride on the rower, run on the treadmill, and also on the cross trainer. So 40 minutes is a long time. So just keep in mind, if you are trying to lose weight, chocolate might be negating your best efforts in that respect as well. In terms of sugar content, another thing to keep in mind is that alcohol is actually a type of sugar, and the body will preferentially use alcohol than any other fats or any other carbohydrate sources. So if you're drinking alcohol and also eating the nuts that we commonly do, or the chips or the chocolate, the body will actually store those other forms in terms of fat. So it will burn the alcohol because it's a toxin considered by the body, and it will store everything else you're eating as fat. So keep that in mind if you're trying to lose weight. Often I see people in the practice and they're very frustrated. They're doing everything they can in terms of diet and exercise, but they're drinking way too much in the evenings. So it's something to keep in mind. That's 100 mils. That's half of that red wine glass a day for women. And men can have two of those a day. But if you're not losing weight, perhaps just keep in mind to reduce that and just leave it for a few days a week. Red wine definitely is more beneficial than beer or white wine in terms of health benefits. So just to summarise, definitely can keep these vices in. They don't have to be thrown out, but keep things to moderation. So alcohol limit, 100 mils for women, five nights a week, and men 200 mils for a night, five nights a week. And chocolate, 50 grams a day if you're not trying to lose weight, or 50 grams a week if you are trying to lose weight. That's it for this time. See you next month.